我们现在回来看阿摩师书。
Okay, let's continue to look at Amos.
阿摩师书的第五章。
Amos chapter 5.
第五章的21节到25节哦，在讲那到底神要什么？
So Amos chapter 5, verse 21 to 25 talks about what does God, what does the Lord require?
我们过一个信仰生活、敬拜神的生活，到底神要什么？
So what is it that God wants from us as we live a life of worship?
如果我们不认识神要什么，我们有时候我们的生活就不知道怎么做。
So if we don't know what God requires from us, then we don't know how to live our life.
那如果我们知道神要什么，我们就容易过一个神喜悦的生活。
But if we do know what God is pleased with, then we know how to live a life that is pleasing to Him.
那第五章21节跟22节就讲他们认为信仰是什么。
And so in verse 22 to 23 talks about what is faith. Verse 21 is about what is faith for them.
21节。
Verse 21.
我厌恶你们的节期，也不喜悦你们的筵素会。22节。
22.
你们虽然向我献燔祭和素祭，我却不悦纳。也不顾你们用肥畜献的平安祭所以这个21节就是在讲守节期，22节就在讲献祭。
Verse 21 talks about observing the feast. 22 is about how they offer.
所以在出埃及记里面，我们可以看到神要他们建立会幕。
So in Exodus, we can see how God asked them to build the tabernacle.
那会幕里面有至圣所。
And in the tabernacle, there is the holiest of holies.
然后至圣所里面有施恩的宝座。至圣所有施恩的宝座。至圣所里面有施恩的宝座。所以神就住在会幕里面。
So God lives in the tabernacle.
Yeah.那与以色列百姓同在。
And he abides with the people of Israel.
所以以色列百姓就是有七个节期，五大献祭。
So there are 7 feasts and 5 festivals.
那到了阿摩斯世代他们还在守节，还在献祭。
And until the time of Amos, they were still offering and keeping the feasts.
所以他们以为就是敬拜神。
So they thought this is how they should worship God.
所以我只要做这个神就会喜悦。
So if I did this, then God will be pleased.
那今天这个对我们来讲什么意思？
So what does that mean to us today?
有时候我们如果不是很深入的去查考圣经，我们常常会觉得我们信耶稣我们的信仰生活最重要就是聚会奉献十一捐。
If we neglect on studying the Bible carefully, then we will end up thinking all I have to do is to go to services and offer tithe.
所以 如果我每个聚会都到，我也限制一间，我就不错的基督徒了。
So if I go to all the services and I offer my tithes, then I'm a good Christian.
聚会这是很好，奉献也是很好。
Attend services is very good, so is giving tithes.
但是有一些是比这个更重要
But then there are things that are more important.
的。所以在当时，神就在讲最重要的你们缺乏。
And this is at the time God asked them, this is what you need to do.
所以25节。
Verse 25.
要是你们的歌唱声音远离我，因为我不听你们弹琴的响声。24节，
24.
我愿公平如大水滚滚，公义如江河滔滔。因为人如果失去了公平跟公义人的献祭、人的守节就不能够蒙神悦纳。
Because if humans neglect justice and righteousness, then their offering and sacrifices means nothing to God.
所以圣经讲神所要的是什么？有三件事情。
So what the Bible tells us, what does God require of us? There are three things in the Bible.
第一个就是要行公义。
First is to do justice.
第二个就是好怜悯。
Second is to love mercy.
第三个要存谦卑的心跟神同行。
Third is to walk humbly with God.
这个是神所喜悦的事。
This is what pleases God.
那如果我们做这三件事情，那我们的献祭跟守节就会蒙神悦纳。
Then our offering, will be pleasing to God.
但是如果我们忽略了这个三件事情，
But if we neglect these three things,
就是行公义、好怜悯、存谦卑的心跟神同行。
and which is to do justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with God.
那我们的聚会奉这里这守节跟献祭就不能够达到神面前。
Then our offering will not be able to be go before God.
所以我们看第三的 BA 外表的崇拜不能够取悦神。
So if we look at the point 3.A, the superficial worship cannot please God.
所以，如果我们的信仰变成表面化，我们跟神的关系就越来越远。
So if our relationship with God is superficial, then we will draw farther and farther away from Him.
所以对当时的时代，神要求是什么？公义如大水滚滚，公平如江河滔滔。
And so what did God require for them is that at that time is that justice is like a is like running down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream.
那公义从哪里来？
Where does this righteousness come from?
我们来看一节圣经节。
So let's look at another verse.
看以赛亚书32章。
Let's turn to Isaiah chapter 32.
15节。
Verse 15.
以赛亚书32章15节。
Isaiah 32, verse 15.
等到圣灵从上面浇灌，旷野就变成肥田，肥田看成树林。16节。
16.
那时，公平要居住在旷野，公义要居住在飞天里面。这个是六节了，第一句话叫“那时
”，and so it says that in verse 16, that the justice will be there.
那时就是指着当15节实现了公平跟公义就有了。
So when this is the word then. So if there's justice and righteous, then the following will be there.
这个地方讲旷野变成肥田。
And so here it says that the justice, the righteousness, justice will dwell in the wilderness.
旷野是什么？
What is the wilderness?
旷野就是人的心嘛。
The wilderness is the heart of man.
啊，那这个旷野因为没有水啊，硬邦邦，你不管撒多少种子，撒啊多好的种子都没有用。
The wilderness, if is the soil is very hard, so it doesn't matter how many seeds you try to sow, it will not grow.
哦，那肥田呢？哦，旷野怎么变成肥田呢？
How can the wilderness become a fruitful field?
哦，上圣灵从上面浇灌下来。
When the Holy Spirit is poured down from above.
哦，圣灵就是活水啊，所以圣灵充满在我们内心啊，我们的心就变肥田。
So the Holy Spirit is a living spring, and so then that way our life can become fruitful.
啊，我们的心呢变肥田了。
And our heart can become a fruitful field.
所以我们听到神的话会受感动。
So when we hear the word of God, we will be moved.
那神的话会感动我们，我们就会改变。
So the word of God is able to move us so that we can change.
所以你看那个当时五旬节哈，彼得起来讲到3000个人啊，好像刀扎心。
And so during the day of the Pentecost, when Peter rose up and spoke, 3,000 people were cut to the heart.
啊，因为圣灵在他们心里面做工了。
And that is because the Holy Spirit was working in their hearts.
所以听过道理以后，他们就问：那我们怎么做？
After hearing the message, they asked Peter, "What shall we do?"
彼得说：你们要悔改。
Peter tells them, "You must repent."
他们真的悔改，开始过新的生活。
And so they all repented and lived a new life.
哦，所以怎么让我们的生活有公义呢？
So how can we let our life have righteousness?
每一天要祷告。
We need to pray daily.
要祷告多久呢？
How long do we need to pray?
祷告到被圣灵充满。
Pray until we are filled with the Holy Spirit.
然后我们不断地去想神的话，听神的话，读神的话。
And so that we continue to read the word and listen to the word of God.
那这样啊，这个种子进去就会开始长大，就到处会变成树林。
So that the seed can grow into a fruitful field.
那我们的生活就会有公义跟公平。
Then in our life, we will have justice and righteousness.
所以啊，神所要的公义和公义就是从这样来的。
So the justice and righteousness that God wants, it comes from this.
好，那我们现在有三个问题，我们来想想看。
So now we have three questions to think about.
第一个，人在危机之中要怎么能够存活？
The first is to think about how we ought to live during a crisis.
我们在阿摩斯书第五章里面学到两个重点。
In Amos chapter 5, we see two main points.
第一个就是要回转向神。
First is they need to return back to the Lord.
第四节哈，寻求神就必存活。
Verse 4, they need to seek the Lord and they will live.
也就是把神当作你整个心思意念生活的这个重心。
That they make God, which means that they make God the center of their life.
这样来追求，我们在危机当中就会渐渐走出一条路。
That and they continue to pursue this, then when they are in the middle of a crisis, they will find a way out.
那第二个就是五章的十四节。
The second is in chapter 5, verse 14.
要求善啊，不要求恶。
Just to seek good and not evil.
也就是要立志过一个神认为对的生活。
Which means that they need to do live a life that is right in the eyes of God.
那这样神就会与我们同在，我们就从危机可以渐渐来走出来。
Then we know that God is abiding with us, and we can slowly walk out of this crisis.
那第二个问题。
Second question.
主同在是一种福气啊，为什么想望主的日子有祸？
So if God's abidance is a blessing, why is it a woe to those who desire the day of the Lord?
我们现在看一节圣经节，《生命记》。
Let's look at a verse in Deuteronomy.
生命记的第二章。
Deuteronomy chapter 2.
生命记第二章的第九节，第七节。
Deuteronomy chapter 2, verse 7.
因为主你的神在你所办的一切事上已经赐福于你，你走这个大而可怕的旷野，他都知道。这四十年，神与你同在，故此你一无所缺。这个最后一句话非常好啊。
And so this last part of this verse is very good.
这个旷野四十年啊，神跟他们同在。
In the 40 years that they were in the wilderness, God was with them.
所以你就一无所缺。
And that is why they lacked nothing.
所以我们的生活如果一无所缺，那就够了，不一定很富有。
And so in our life, if we lack nothing, that is enough.
那怎么会一无所缺呢？因为神跟我们同在。
And how can we lack nothing? It is only when God is with us.
所以神同在是福气啊。
So if God's being with us, abidance is a blessing.
那我们回到阿摩斯书第五章讲，想望神的日子有祸了。
But in Amos chapter 5, it says that there is... When the day of the Lord, there's woe.
因为他们活在罪里面，不愿意改变。
This is because they were living in sin and were unwilling to change.
所以旷野很多人体验到神的恩典，但是也有很多人死在旷野。
So in the, while they, people, the Israelites were in the wilderness, there were many people who were blessed, but there were also many who perished.
因为神真的跟他们同在，借着约柜。
Because God was with them, truly with them, through the Ark of Covenant.
但是不愿意顺服神，不愿意寻求神，就走不下去，就是了。
But those who were unwilling to submit to God, or seek after God, then they die.
所以这不是神不爱他们，是他们不愿意改变。
It was not that God did not love them, but that they were unwilling to change.
那第三个问题。
The third question.
如何不让信仰表面化？
How can we let our faith not become superficial?
因为信仰如果表面化，我们跟神的关系就越来越疏远。
And because if our faith becomes superficial, then we are farther, falling farther and farther away from God.
这个就好像什么？好像婚姻啊，婚姻如果变成表面化，这个婚姻就维持不久。
It's like a marriage. If a marriage is superficial, then it will not be able to sustain itself.
那我们跟神的信仰啊，要从表面往要深入。
And so our relationship with God must be deep and intimate.
所以圣经说，拜神要用心灵跟诚实来拜他。
Because we must worship the Lord in spirit and in truth.
也就是要用心呐，来拜神。
And we must worship the Lord in spirit with our hearts.
用心来爱神。
And with our heart, we must love God.
把那个心拿掉，信仰就变成表面了。
If we remove this love, then it becomes a superficial faith.
把那个心拿回来，信仰就变成活的。
And if we bring back this type of heart, then our faith can be revived.
所以我们在很舒服的环境里面不要让心跑掉，跑到世界去。
And so while we live in a comfortable environment, we should not let our heart run away and go into the world.
那这样我们信仰就会表面化。在很舒服环境里面，如果我们的心在紧紧跟随神，我们对神的体验还是会很活泼，很有力量。
Because if we keep our heart in the Lord, even if we live in a prosperous society, we can still have a deep relationship with God and have a very lively faith.
但是这非常不简单。
However, this is very difficult.
所以我们进到下面一章。
So we will look at the latter part,
就是第六章。
Which is in chapter 6.
这个第六章就在讲如果我们看第一节。
Look at verse 1.
请读。
Verse 1. Woe to you who are ease in Zion and trust in Mount Samaria, notable persons in the chief nation to whom the house of Israel comes.
这个第一节讲国为列国之首，人而且很出名，这个大家都要啊。
And so for this, to be at ease and to trust in these notable persons, these are what everybody wants.
国为列国之首就是国家很强盛啊。
And so to be at have ease means that everybody, that the country is very prosperous and powerful.
然后下面啊。安逸无虑的生活。
And at the end, it says they are at ease, they have a peaceful life.
哦，这个是我们大家都把这个当做这是神的恩典，神的祝福。
We all think of this as a peace, as a grace of God, a blessing.
但是这里反而在讲这样有祸了。
But here it says, woe to those who are at ease.
啊，那我们就来看啊。当时的人怎么生活
？So we can look at how the people of this time, how did they live?
啊，好，如果我们看啊第四节
，Let's look at verse four.
啊，你们躺卧在象牙床上，舒身在榻上，吃云中的羊羔，棚里的牛足。啊，第五节
，Verse five，
弹琴鼓瑟，唱消闲歌曲，为自己制造乐器，如同大卫所造。用大碗喝酒，用上等油抹身，却不为约瑟的苦难担忧。啊，那当时的生活真的是很享受。
And so, the people at this time truly lived very comfortable lives.
所以第四节讲哦，象牙床，哇，这个是很贵重的。
They lived in beds of ivory, which is very expensive.
那下面哦，舒身的榻上，以今天来讲就很好的沙发。
And so they were stretched out on couches, so it must be a comfortable couch.
那现在下面哦，吃的是羊羔牛犊，就是最好吃的。
So they eat lamb and calf, which is the best meat.
那第五节哈，有很多这个什么娱乐器材，弹琴鼓瑟，唱消闲歌曲。
So there's a lot of singing, and maybe pop music.
然后用大碗喝酒大碗就是很放纵的喝酒。
So they had these bowls of wine, meaning that they drank a lot.
所以你可以想当时的生活的充满着笑声，大家活得好快乐。
So you can imagine that they lived very happily. Everybody was very comfortable.
那用上等油抹身。
And they anointed themselves with the best ointments.
现在来讲最好的化妆品保养皮肤。
And so you can think of it as the best skincare that they can beautify themselves.
那这样的生活不是我们现在一直在追求的吗？
If we think about it, isn't this the type of life that we are currently pursuing?
但是第一节讲安逸无虑，这是灾祸。
But here in verse 1, it says, woe to those who are at ease.
那安逸这个神的恩典怎么会变灾祸呢？
How can this blessing from God become a woe?
我们先看生命记再回来看这几节。
And so let's turn to Deuteronomy before we come back.
我们看生命记的第第八章。
Deuteronomy chapter 8.
生命记第八章
Deuteronomy chapter 8
十一节
verse 11
你要谨慎，免得忘记神主你的神，不遵守他的诫命啊，典章律例，就是我今日所吩咐你的。十二节。
Verse 12.
我恐怕你吃得饱足啊，建造美好的房屋居住。十三节。
13.
你的牛羊增多，你的金银增加，并你所有全都增加。十四节。
14.
你就心高气傲，忘记主你的神，就是从埃及为奴之家带领出来的神。你看到这里啊，神已经借着摩西在预告啊，以色列百姓进入迦南会产生什么事情。
And so, here we can see that what will happen, and as a warning to when they enter the land of Canaan.
哦，那迦南地是牛奶与蜜的地方啊。
And so, the land of Canaan is a place, a land of milk and honey.
会非常的丰盛。
So it is very prosperous and fruitful.
哦，所以生活过得很好。
So they are able to live very well.
所以你看，有美好的房子，有牛羊，有金银。
So they had beautiful homes. They had great herds and flocks.
啊，但是人一旦到那个情况，就心高气傲，忘记神。
But when in that type of environment, their heart was lifted up, and they forgot the Lord.
啊，所以雅各祷告哈，他在求神说，不要让我太富足。
And so, here it says, to not let us be too.
真言,
in Proverbs, King Agur says that to not let him be too wealthy.
啊，也不要太贫穷。
And or not, and to not be too poor.
啊，太贫穷当然不好守道。
Because if you are poor, then it is difficult to keep.
生活太舒服也不好守道。
Oh, when your life is too comfortable, it's difficult to keep the word of God.
哦，这个不但是《生命记》神的预告，到阿摩斯世代真的是这样出现。
And so the warning in Deuteronomy, and to see it actually come to fruition in the time of Amos.
哦，所以我们回来看阿摩斯的第六章。
So let us turn back to Amos chapter 6.
第六章的第六节最后一句，不为约瑟的苦难担忧。
Amos chapter 6, verse 6, the last part, but are not grieved for the affliction of Joseph.
什么是约瑟的苦难？
What is the affliction of Joseph?
约瑟的苦难就是约瑟被卖到埃及去。
The affliction of Joseph is that he was sold into Egypt.
啊，所以约瑟有两个儿子吧，一个叫马拉西，一个叫以法莲。
And so Joseph had two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim.
啊，那其中一个意思就是神使我忘记了我的痛苦。
And so the name of their name meaning that God has helped me to forget my troubles.
啊，所以约瑟在埃及确实很痛苦。
And so it is true that while Joseph was living in Egypt, he was had a difficult time.
哦，那这个阿摩斯世代生活很舒服，但是人开始忘记了神，过了罪的生活啊，那被掳的日子就快到了。
And so for the people during Amos's time, for them to forget and live in their prosperity means that the time of their judgment is coming.
那是一种苦难。
In a way, this is a affliction.
但是人生活在舒服当中，他不会想这个。
And, but if those who are living in prosperity, they will not think about this.
我天天活得很好，怎么有可能的事情会发生呢？
If I live so well daily, how would this, how can this such calamity happen?
我们国家这么强盛，又怎么会灭亡呢？
If our country is so strong, how can it be destroyed?
所以如果他们为约瑟的苦难担忧，他们就会改变了。
And so they, if they had grieved for the affliction of Joseph, then they would have changed.
哇，苦难在前面，那我们怎么办？
So they know that affliction is ahead, so what should they do?
我们要来寻求神。
So they will think to return back to God.
这样他们就会改变了。
And in this way, they can change and return.
所以一个人活在很舒服的环境里面, 你跟他讲世界末日, 谁听得下去呢?
And so when a people is living comfortably in their life, and you tell them that the world will be come to an end, who will believe?
所以圣经怎么在讲挪亚的世代?
And so here, the Bible tells us about the people in the time of Noah.
好，我们看马太福音24章。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 24.
马太福音24章。
Matthew chapter 24.
37节。
Verse 37.
马太24章37节。
Matthew chapter 24, verse 37.
摩亚的日子怎样, 人子降临也要怎样, 38节。
38.
当洪水以前的日子, 人照常吃喝嫁娶, 直到挪亚进方舟的那日, 39节。
39.
不知不觉洪水来, 把他们全部都冲去, 人子降临也是这样。 这里讲主耶稣再来的日子, 要像挪亚的日子。
So here, it says, tells us that the day of Jesus Christ coming again will be the same as in the days of Noah.
那挪亚的日子就是人照常吃喝嫁娶。
And so in the days of Noah, they were eating and drinking and marrying.
其实吃喝是神的恩典。
To eat and drink is a blessing of God.
所以圣经说神让我们饮食饱足满心喜乐。
Because in the Bible tells us that we can eat and be happy in our hearts.
那嫁娶有幸福的家庭也是神的恩典。
To be able to marry and to give in marriage and to have a happy family life is also a blessing of God.
那为什么要特别提到吃喝嫁娶?
So why does it specifically mention about the eating, drinking, and marrying?
也就是说，这个变成生活的。 焦点，好像照向那个焦点。
And so this became the focus or the of their life.
好像照向有一个焦点了。
And like a in a camera when you take a picture.
有一个 focus 啊。
Oh God! So this became the focus of their life.
哦，那。 这样的话，我们对神的事情就变成不知不觉。And
so during this, as a result of this, then they would not care about the word of God.
其实挪亚常常去传警告啊。Because
Noah often would give warning to them.
哦，但是他心不在那里。But
their hearts were not there.
哦，所以那个世代全部都被冲走。
And so as a result, all the people of this generation were taken away by the flood.
所以我们在信仰生活不要羡慕别人生活水准多高，这个真的不是我们需要去羡慕。And
so in our life, we should not be envious of those who are living in luxury because that should not be the focal point of our life.
要羡慕就是人活在神的恩典当中，又能够很警醒的来追求信仰，来侍奉。Instead,
we should be focused that in our life we can continue to serve the Lord.
这样才是我们信仰生活的榜样。And
that is the example that we must look at.
所以阿摩斯的世代安无虑。
And so the people in the time of Amos,
但是神说他们有灾祸了。Though
they lived in prosperity, but God said that calamity was coming.
我们明天再继续，我们现在一起来祷告。
We will continue tomorrow. Now we will kneel down and pray together.